This supports my new book, Fishing the Edge, Techniques and Tales from Surf, Boat, and Kayak, a bestseller on Amazon. Hey, it would make a great holiday gift. You can learn more at johnskinnerfishing.com and on Amazon. Oh, this is going to be fun. Hey, we don't see this much anymore. Boy, this used to be, I don't want to say a common occurrence, but wow, yeah, this is special. What more can you say? All right, let's get to it. Okay, just stepping onto the beach, and I'm going to do really minimal editing on this one. I want it to play through. I want you to see exactly everything that's going on. All right, clearly a good school of fish here. I'm throwing 1 and 1.5 ounce bucktails. They're tipped with fat cow jig strips, 5-inch. And I'll have links to all of the gear in the video description. And if you like this video, please hit the like button. If you're not already a subscriber, please subscribe and hit that notification bell. Okay, if you look in the water in front of me, you can see bait going by. Those are bay anchovies. There are some big ones and there are some very small ones. Kind of a mix. Yep, crushed barb as usual, so that jig's gonna come right out. Hey, you know what? I'm gonna edit 2 casts out here. Huh. Okay, I kind of walked into the tail end of that and got a fish there on the first cast. They've moved out, so I've just switched my 1 ounce jig to 1.5 ounces to get a little extra distance. There, I'll give you a quick look here at what's considered a large bay anchovy. Yeah, that's a good size one right there. The other ones that are here are much, much smaller. And you'll see schools of those in a bit. All right, the rod is the Dark Matter Skinner 8-footer. The reel is a Tsunami Saltex 4000, and you can get those things for $299 because they're going to come out with a new version. It's not out yet. These are discounted quite a bit. There's a link in the video description to the reel, but I love it. I mean, it's kind of reel I use for this stuff. All right, the main line is 20 braid, leader is 50-pound Seaguar fluorocarbon, and there's a tactical angler's clip between the leader and the jig. So I want to be able to change jigs easily without having to cut off every time. Okay, note that there are no visible fish anymore. I'm basically fishing residuals from that school that was here when I walked onto the beach. Okay, the limit on these is 28 to 31 inches. You can keep one. I'd never keep any striper, so they're all going back. And yeah, there'll be a fair number of fish that are going to be big enough to keep. All right, it's a rocky bottom here, so I'm going to let that jig settle just a couple seconds, and then slow to moderate retrieve. You just want to swim the jig over the structure. You'll get them. All right, you might notice that reel has no bail. That's because it comes with a bailless conversion kit, which I immediately do because I don't want the bail. But yeah, the reel ships with a bail. I'm going to make one fishless cast after that fish, but then I'm going to look down the shore and the mother load's coming in. I got to walk down there and get on these things. Many times you'll see a reddish tinge to the water, like just off to my left there. That's all bait. That's all bay anchovies. Challenge is I can't cast right into that because I'm going to get my line caught on a bird, so I got to kind of work the fringes. Plus my jig strip. Hey, when you hook these things on, don't put it through the pre-cut hole. Push it through, make a new hole. It'll stay on longer.
False albacore.
Yeah, a couple of false albacore slashing through the bait. Not on my line. That's bass. I won't get an albie on that bucktail.
Thank you. perfect. Look at this.
If you look in the light-colored water in front of me, you're going to see hundreds and hundreds of bass just swimming by. Now, a lot of times when those fish are just swimming by like that, like they are now, they can be pretty picky. You see, I'm not getting hit, but consider that those fish are also swimming through a lot of bait, and they're not reacting to that either. All right, something to note when I get closer is those streaks of brown going right up to the sand. That's all bait.
Look at this. You just don't see them blitz like this anymore. Oh. That's a good one. Here we go.
Oh man, when it's going on like this, you think it's going to go on forever, but this turns out to be my last fish, the smallest one of the bunch. When that school went through, it just like a vacuum cleaner, just sucked everything right out of there. I actually went all the way down to that point to my left, past that boat, blind casted that for a bit, and nothing else. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. If you did, please hit the like button. If you're not already a subscriber, please subscribe and hit that notification bell. Check out my online courses at saltstrong.com/skinner and my new Northeast Fishing message board over on SaltStrong. There's a link to that in the video description. And don't forget my books, including my new book, Fishing the Edge, Techniques and Tales from Surf, Boat, and Kayak, available at johnskinnerfishing.com and on Amazon.